bagi setiap bidang bertujuan untuk meningkatkan minat pelajar sekolah, guru-guru, dan komuniti untuk menceburkan diri dalam bidang STEM. Turut dimaklumkan bahawa bagi sesi pada hari ini adalah sama seperti sesi-sesi sebelum ini, di mana e-sijil akan diberikan kepada pelajar-pelajar sekolah dan juga ibu bapa serta guru-guru dan ahli komuniti yang hadir. Tetapi silalah bersama dengan kami sehingga akhir program, di mana kita akan kongsikan pautan dan juga QR code yang boleh diimbas untuk diisi bagi salinan e-sijil berkenaan. Okay. Dengan itu, silalah bersama-sama kami sehingga program tamat pada hari ini. Dan sekiranya terdapat sebarang pertanyaan daripada pihak penceramah, sila utarakan di dalam kotak chat pada sebelah kanan YouTube live ini, atau ianya akan dijawab oleh pihak penceramah pada akhir sesi ini. Okay. Bagi pengenalan untuk penceramah jemputan pada hari ini, bersama-sama kita adalah seorang ahli akademik daripada Fakulti Kejuruteraan Universiti Malaysia Sabah, iaitu Dr. Nor Shina Heriani Harif, dan beliau adalah pencara kanan daripada Program Kejuruteraan Awam Universiti Malaysia Sabah. Sebagai pengenalan, beliau telah memperoleh ijazah Doktor Falsafah dalam bidang Kejuruteraan Awam daripada Universiti Teknologi Malaysia, iaitu UTM, Sarjana Kejuruteraan Awam, dan ijazah Sarjana Muda dalam bidang Kejuruteraan Awam daripada Universiti Sains Malaysia, USM. Penyelidikan Dr. Nor Shina adalah tertumpu kepada kejuruteraan seismik. Okay. Dan beliau adalah penerima bagi pelbagai geran penyelidikan yang menjurus kepada kejuruteraan seismik ini. Dan selain dari berkhidmat sebagai koordinator dalam program mobiliti dan pelajar antarabangsa. Beliau juga merupakan koordinator bagi program latihan industri bagi Fakulti Kejuruteraan. Selain daripada itu, beliau juga Seismik Engineering. Dipersilakan, Doktor.
Terima kasih kepada Chairman. Okay, let me share my slides sekejap ya. Boleh dengar suara saya, kan?
Okay, jelas.
Okay. Assalamualaikum and good morning to secondary school students, the Brown University students. Assalamualaikum and good morning to secondary school students, the Brown University students. different types of black boundaries. So the different there are of plate boundaries we call as a divergent. Okay, the plate tectonics if divert means that move apart from each other. So plate tectonic, another plate tectonic that move apart from each other.
Different types of
or we have so convergent.
Convergent,
the other plate tectonic and one plate tectonic are moved together.
As a divergent.
Yeah,
okay, the plate
convergence is the vertical under the satellite.
Means that
and then we have
the
third type of tectonics we call as a
that move apart from each other.
So it's passing.
We have two
each other.
So
the other plate tectonic.
So to illustrate this divergence, so if we have one plate and then the left one and to the right one, the plate boundaries. So it will move apart. It move apart from one tectonic to one tectonic. So it move away from each other. So when it move away from each other, it can create these volcanoes activities. Lah, okay, convergent, satu plate bertembung dengan satu plate dan di mana plate yang lebih kuat, okay, the crust tebal dan lebih kuat, dia akan pergi ke bawah. So yang lebih kurang kuat, the lesser strength will go up. Okay, so it will create the deeper earthquake. Okay, biasanya kita nampak dalam lautan lah, this type of crust. And also it can create volcanoes activities. Okay, tapi we'll go see into detail on the part of this convergence. And then the third one we can say it's transformed. So it pass through each other. The plate tectonic is just passing through each other. So it's slide down, jump. Jalan satu ke kiri dan satu ke kanan. So all these type of plate boundaries that can create the earthquake activity as well as the volcano activity. For the case of transform activities, it can only create the earthquake. Okay.
So it's like jalan satu.
Right. So this is where we have the garisan-garisan adalah plate tectonic lah that we have around the world. We actually have 15 major earthquakes. Tak besarlah plate tectonic. For example, Pacific plate ni paling besarlah plate tectonic kita ada in our world.
So,
so is in this map you can see that this has been summarized.
Do we have
three different plate boundaries? Yang warna biru dan is called as a divergent
major
plate boundaries. The divergent property. Divergent is moving away from each other. Semua yang the blue line is actually called as divergent. So ada volcano, ada plate boundaries. And then the dark blue called as a
divergent.
So convergent is bertemu. Thank you.
But these same forces created magnificent features, with each adding character to a planet so unique.
Okay, that's all for the video. Hope you enjoyed the video. Sorry for the technical problem just now. Kita perasan pula tadi suara. Okay, so now you can know the plate tectonic that creates the earthquake and then what the consequences that we have if the earthquake happened in our country. So let's focus ourselves in our plate tectonics around Malaysia. So we are living on the south of erosion plate, cut through a small plate, so it called as a Sunda plate. So we are living under the plate of Sunda, right? And then under Sunda plate, we actually felt the earthquake from our neighboring country, for example, from Philippines, from Sulawesi, and also from the Indonesia. Okay, so most of this earthquake actually creates by these countries, these three countries, because of the movement of the plate itself. So for example, we have this we call as a Philippine Sea plate. Okay, dalam dekat atas tu belah kanan. Okay, kita kat sini kan sama. So under the Philippine trench, this is we are under the Philippine Sea plate. The movement of this plate is 10 cm per year. Okay, dalam satu tahun tu dia bergerak 10 cm. Okay, going to northwest. Northwest dia dekat atas sana lah. And then from our below south of Malaysia, so we have we call as a plate. The Indian Ocean plate move 7 cm per year. So satu tahun dia bergerak 7 cm, okay, ke to the south, okay, ke arah kita lah. So that's why we also receive some can felt the shaking from our neighboring country. Okay, for example, what happened during the 2004 earthquake with 9.0 magnitude that created tsunami, then Malaysia also have the aftermath effect from that earthquake. So that's why we also received some the shaking from our neighboring now we can, for example, what happened
in 2004. Four pictures is the boundary spot. But four pictures, four is what we have on land.
Okay, dia ada macam garisan-garisan sesat lah.
So what is four pictures? Okay, what is four? Okay, the four is the rupture in the earthquake. There are displacement. Okay, displacement on our land. It just creates earthquake. And sometimes it's not create earthquake. Sometimes it's so di dalam our fault line, we can see the epicenter. Trajectory from this focus to the surface, so we call as the epicenter.
and we extend the
Hello doktor. Mungkin ada masalah dengan doktor, ada
saya tak tahu
ya.
Ya, tadi enggak?
Sekarang okey sudah sikit. Yang tadi tu ada putus-putus sikit doktor, yang bahagian map tadi. Mungkin boleh ulang balik sikit doktor, yang bahagian
map yang mana? Peninsula.
Yes, betul.
Ya. Sorry ya, Sarawak lah.
Yes,
betul. Sorry ya, line saya tak berapa bagus.
Yang tadi tu ada putus sikit doktor.
Tunggu tu tadi. Boleh saya
tak? Memang putus.
Oh, okey. Okay, sorry.
Okay, doktor.
Sorry for the apa ni line problem. Okay. So, boleh dengar suara kan? Alright. So, in Sarawak, okay, Peninsula, we have some server fault line. Tapi di Sarawak, we actually has server fault line that produce this earthquake. Tapi there are only three main fault that considered active by the geologists of Sarawak. We call as the Tubau fault, and then down the one around the Lupar fault, and Bukit Mersing fault. Fault tahu kan the terms of fault on the earth surface that creates the earthquake. Okay, now we move to our state below the state Sabah. Okay, Sabah is actually has a complex types of faults because there are so many lines. Okay, so in we've been discussing with this fault line with the geologists and JKR and other government agency around Sabah, and we managed to identify that the earthquake around Ronau fault, because there are so many lines. Okay, so in we've been discussing with this fault line with the geologists and JKR and other government agency around Sabah, and we managed to identify that the earthquake around Ronau fault, because there are so many lines. Okay, so in we've been discussing with this fault line with the geologists and JKR and other government agency around Sabah, and we managed to identify that the earthquake around Ronau fault, because there are so many lines. So in we've been discussing with this fault line with the geologists and JKR and other government agency around Sabah, and we it move lah macam S tu lah, bentuk S. Okay, so it goes up, then with moving to left to the right. And then the surface wave is the face of the earth, so we call it a surface wave. So there are two types, we call it as a love wave. Kalau kita go kiri kanan, the surface wave kiri kanan kiri kanan, so we call it as a love wave or Rayleigh wave. So there are creates this gelombang, okay, on the surface of the earth, so we call it as a Rayleigh wave. Okay, how we detect this earthquake movement? So ni video tak ada suara lah. Okay, so first earthquake coming, and then the sensor will detect the P wave, and then kita on the surface garanya, and then we felt the S wave lebih strong. Okay, S wave biasanya lebih kuat lah dia punya getaran, and measured dekat kita punya seismic station lah, measured how big is the earthquake.
And then
so inside our seismic station, we actually has this seismometer that recorded this earthquake. How big is the earthquake? So the data will come from the earthquake, and then seismic wave will create that the wave, and then kita akan terima that data to the seismograph, and then from that we actually has this seismograph how big is the earthquake. And then we actually has installed most of the seismic station around Pulau Sabah and Sarawak. Ia adalah yang kuning-kuning ni, orange color, the dotted orange color is actually the seismic station that we have around Sabah. Okay, to detect earthquake is coming.
And then
dekat Sarawak. Tapi ni in 2004 lah. We actually has installed seismic station nowadays. Okay. From Sabah and Sarawak.
Ini adalah yang kuning-kuning ni, orange color, the dot.
Okay, so
actually the seismic station that we have from Sabah. Okay, to detect earthquake is coming. And then dekat Sarawak. Tapi ni
ini pertama kali ni.
We actually has installed seismic station.
On the last part, we'll touch on the earthquake engineering. So this is kita punya more on to the technology lah that we have in our earthquake engineering. Okay, apa beza seismic and earthquake engineering? Okay, seismology and earthquake engineering. Okay, if we have the seismology engineering, maknanya we measure the length of fault, the sources of earthquake, maknanya below the ground lah, seismic engineering. Okay, this is taken from my professor in the USM. So the term is like this lah, as seen in this figure. So below this, kita panggil engineering, seismology. Di atas melibatkan bangunan, structure, roads, dams, itu we call as earthquake engineering. But before we go to earthquake engineering, we have to measure all the parameters below the ground. So kita kena tahu dia punya jenis jenis fault inside our ground, the seismic wave, how we have to measure the seismic wave and the soil type. If that kadang-kadang earthquake happen, and then this different soil type might tingkatkan lagi shaking below the ground. So there are some population lah that we need to perform our building design, previous design. Okay, so before we design everything,
okay, so far
doctor. Oh, okay. Sebab saya tengok, internet saya on off lah. Okay, saya continue. Okay, so this is where we actually relate that seismology engineering to the earthquake engineering. So the engineer and the geologist might take care of these parameters, okay, so that the building that we are living,
set up your OBS studio,
terselamatlah duduk dalam bangunan tu atau di mana-mana kita berada lah. Okay, this is the relation between the earthquake and seismic engineering. Okay, for example, if we have fault, okay, we have already measured the fault line, the length of the fault line, the depth of fault, the magnitude of earthquake that produced by this fault, and we can see that the closer the building close to the fault, is going to damage that building. Kan? Kalau kita tengok sini, dia lebih dekat, so building ni collapse lah, collapse. And then jauh sikit dia akan damage. And then, jauh lagi sikit lah. Okay, and then far away from that fault, it will be safe. Tapi kalau ini selamat lah, what happened to this close to the fault? So this is where engineering, seismic engineering has to take care of this issue. Okay, so how we have to take care of the people inside this building so that their building will be safely live inside. So so in order to check the building is safe or not, and what we have to do so that the people is safe, so we can have take care of the people analysis on the earthquake resistance. For example, we do it lab testing using the checking table, or we do the field work building survey to monitor the building capabilities if they can sustain the earthquake loads or not. And then we transform the building drawing into the design analysis using a specific software. So shaking table, okay, this is the types of shaking table. It is a very massive shaking table that we have, I think. Kita tak adalah dalam Malaysia. This is from overseas lah. They will put one platform and put the shake table. Okay, this is yang kat bawah ni shake table lah. And then they will check this real size building and then see the damage that can be that have inside this building. So kita akan dapat monitor lah the building damage kat mana-kat mana. Tapi dia sangat besar lah dan very very costly. Then this is dia punya lab lah. Lab dia pun sudah besar macam to monitor this building. Okay, this is dekat China. So this is very massive and very big types of shaking table. You can see that this building is betul-betul size building betul. And then from here we can observe the swaying of this building and how what is the shaking level will be apa ni impact to this building. Kita boleh tengoklah the type of shaking building, kat rosak dekat mana. So we can measure and observe directly. Okay, yang ni yang saya punya lah kat lab, we call as a small scale, ni tak ada suara lah. Small scale punya shake table lah. This is for ini my, and we have able to create this small scale so that we macam for educational purpose, so we can see that building how the building sway left to right, and we can measure using the smartphone the vibration punya ketinggian, how big is the vibration can take can this building. Okay, so this is a sample daripada apa ni kayu lah. Okay, but this is cost only less than 100 ringgit. So this is for education purpose. So yang ni reusable item using the back of the fan, kan ada belakang kipas tu kan, dia pusing. So we use that and install to this small scale shaking table. And then we upgrade the checking table into this. So we buy something that power supply, okay, so that it can control the vibration level. Okay, kita nak kuat atau slow. And then we also put different types of model inside the shaking table. Okay, this is the unbreak structure model. Ini yang tak ada ciri-ciri keselamatan lah, the building that without apa ni safety. And then we install the brace structure model. We ada letak bracing system lah. And then yang ni the tune mesh damper, kita letak like besi lah at the center of the building to monitor the shaking. And then the base isolator, so we just put the spring lah below the model so that how it shakes. So yang ni macam most of the project that we done is for the students. Tapi tak saya tak ada pula video dia, so saya boleh share lah. So from the shaking table, so we the student touch and monitor the building itself, whether it has a crack or not, how big high is the building, the types of building, because we have so many type of building. We have reinforced concrete building, we have wood, and we have steel. So this is the all this need, we need to have this necessary information for our building, and there are some form that we need to check whether this building required a seismic protection or not. Okay, this is currently under my project lah. Sekarang ni masih tengah buat ini lah. And then for example this we can monitor the buildings. Okay, the year it's built, for example Yayasan Sabah is 1976, it has 32 story, LHDN 10 story, PPMS is 33 story. Okay, and then the type of building for residential, residential, so it's during 2017, and one volume we have 28 story. So after we check and see from the field inspection study, so now we can transfer to our design analysis using a software. So usually I use the SAP 2000 software. So put everything, the parameters inside the software, so if we observe which of the which technologies can apply to our current building, whether we can use a base isolator, viscous damper, or chilled mass damper. So for the base isolator, so it's actually dalam atas span lah, spring lah, bawah building tu. So this is conventional structure building. Kita letak piling without anything to support and sustain the earthquake load. Tapi dia punya sway, dia akan nak sway lah, kita tengok dekat bahagian atas fail damage lah. Okay, this is no base isolation. So what happen if we put the seismic isolation using base isolator? So it will shake left to right, sway left to right. So the building will not sustain certain damage level lah. Alright, and then the second technology is we use a viscous damper. Saya letak hydraulic device. So when the earthquake stroke, it's macam dissipate the energy placed to the structure by seismic event. So the concept is by converting the kinetic energy of the structure movement into heat and dissipate the energy. So this is the structure remain elastic. So if we put all the viscous damper inside your buildings, so that when the earthquake coming, it will dissipate the energy from the shaking into this mechanical instrument. So the building will save lots, so reduce the damage on the building. And the last one we call, this is a video that's an example where we don't have the viscous damper, and this is the figure that we have the viscous damper. So we can see that the shaking is actually being absorbed into this viscous damper and reduce the shaking to the building. And then the last technology is we call it, this is the newest damper, and this first been installed in Taipei 101, we call as a tune mass sample or TMD. So this is some information that TMD is actually the structure to reduce mechanical vibration. Okay, we have this TMD. So the shaking of the building will store into this TMD. So it will reduce overall shaking into this robot or the building system. It will reduce the damage on the building and guarantee the safety of the people. Okay, so that's all presentation. So I pass to the secretariat, the science secretariat, for the next session. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Doctor, for the very fruitful and informative session here today, Doctor. Unfortunately, our technical is a bit down today, so we apologize to all the participants today, and we are very sorry from our part, Doctor, not from Doctor's part. Yeah, but we do have a questions, Doctor. Yeah, from our some of our participant have PM. One of the question is bagi model seismik yang dimakmal tu tadi, Doktor, sekiranya ada pelajar ataupun ada guru-guru yang berminat dengan model
ada viscous damper, kita ada tune mass damper. Sebenarnya untuk pemasangan ni sangat-sangat costly. So sometimes developer tak mau pasang ni because of the cost. Tapi sangat-sangat selamat sebenarnya if we have more than 4 stories building, so that the building can sustain the load from the earthquake. So dia tak kurang damage and then people will selamat lah. Ya, cuma itu dari segi kos lah. Kami kita juga beberapa presentation regarding to this awareness ya to the people, but we actually kekangan lah dari segi kos lah. Ya.
Okay, baik.
Sudah banyak dan sudah berkembang pun satu Malaysia.
Betul. So in terms of cost lah kan, mungkin akan menjadi question kepada ni developer. Baik, Doktor. Bagi sesi pada hari ini, itu sahaja soalan yang ada. Mungkin kita akan jemput lagi Doktor bagi barang ceramah bagi topik-topik akan datang ya, Doktor. So kita ucapkan terima kasih berbanyak, terima kasih kepada pihak Doktor atas sokongan dan juga memberikan komitmen bagi penceramah pada hari ini ya, Doktor. So kita akhiri webinar. Kita akan akhiri topik webinar pada hari ini dan kita akan kongsikan QR code kepada peserta. Sila scan ataupun imbas QR code di paparan skrin anda dan sila isikan butiran-butiran bagi permohonan ECG lah. Dan kita akan jumpa pada sesi akan datang pula dengan topik yang lain. Pada hari Jumaat ini, kita akan bersama-sama dengan penceramah Dr. Sylvester Mantihal bagi topik 3D Food Printing. Bagi sesi hari ini, kita ucapkan terima kasih sekali lagi Doktor atas sokongan dan juga atas komitmen. Dan kita akhiri sesi pada hari ini dengan ucapan sekian. Terima kasih. Terima kasih Doktor.
Terima kasih semua. Bye. Sampai jumpa lagi.
Bye, Doktor.
kasih semua.